Joining me now is Robby Mook, the former Clinton campaign chairman. Robby, thanks for joining us. So you heard Brianna's report. The memo says your campaign got to weigh in on who the communications director was before the general election. Was that fair?
Well, first of all, Anderson, I just want to underscore some things Brianna said. First of all, when the DNC approached both campaigns about a joint fundraising agreement, they were broke. They weren't going to make payroll. They were not going to be able to transfer down money to the state parties to keep them operational. They were in a really bad place. Both the Sanders campaign and the Clinton campaign signed joint fundraising agreements. So we both thought it was a good thing to sign up for. The only difference was Sanders didn't raise any money in, and we did. The DNC appealed to us.
So Sanders was raising money in it. I mean, you guys had big money donors. Sanders was getting more donations from you know, individuals and smaller donations. No.
Well, and that would have been great. It would have been great for the DNC to raise jointly with him. Hillary turned over her email list to the DNC after the election was over. So it's really important for those low dollar donors to be part of the DNC process. But the DNC came to our campaign and said, we need help. We're not prepared for the general election. We created the memo of understanding that was there. It wasn't about the primary election. And as Brianna said, we were very frustrated with the DNC many times. The idea that we had any control over there is pretty laughable.
Right,
we simply put guardrails in about how the money that we raised needed to be focused on the general election activities that were really going to matter.
Right, but my understanding is that communications position actually had to be filled even before the primary races.
Well, that's correct. I mean, this is a perfect example.
So that wasn't just about the general election, right?
Well, no, but it absolutely is. The purpose of the DNC while a primary is going on is to hold Republican candidates accountable. And there was nobody filling that post. It was a big problem. It was something that any Democrat should have been worried about. That's why if you look in that memo, we explicitly set a date whereby they have to hire someone because we were distressed that there was no lead voice out there speaking out against Donald Trump and Ted Cruz and everybody else.
But was the Sanders campaign also offered the chance to enter into an agreement where they too could have a say in who the DNC was hiring?
They were. And if you look at the memo that came out this evening, it explicitly says in that memo that we as the Clinton campaign acknowledged that other campaigns were welcome to enter into agreement with the DNC of their own. In fact, honestly, Anderson, we would have beyond welcomed that. More resources coming into the DNC. We would have loved to have partnered with the Sanders campaign, talking about all the issues of how to organize and prepare for the general election. We had a very good working relationship with the Sanders campaign, particularly as the primary came to a close. I worked very closely with Jeff Weaver. We got a lot done. We got the Unity Commission that's there set up.
But we would have welcomed that.
Right,
but clearly Jeff Weaver and the Sanders campaign believes that things were rigged against them.
Well, here's what I'll say about this. You know, politics is politics. People have to go there, go out there and say what they need to say. I think it's dangerous to say that this contest was rigged for the following reason.
Because Elizabeth Warren, by the way, is also saying that now.
Well, and Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders are important members of our party. They're an important part of our politics. We can't make the case to working people in this country that we're going to stand up for them and we're going to fight for them if we're fighting each other. We can't do that. Hillary Clinton won this primary with almost 4 million votes. That's a bigger lead than Barack Obama had over her when she lost and conceded in 2008. The idea that the DNC could rig a contest, frankly, is laughable. And here's the last thing I'll say. You know, the caucus contests within the larger primary are the contests that are run by the party. You know, the primary elections are run by secretaries of state. Those contests, the caucuses that were run by the party, Bernie Sanders won overwhelmingly. So if we look at what the party actually managed in this process, Bernie Sanders won those contests. I think we only won 3 of them, and we barely won Iowa. So there's just no evidence to back this up. I understand how it's convenient. Some people they want to be angry at what's going on. But we've got to focus our anger on Donald Trump and this outrageous tax plan that the Republicans are proposing.
So is this just about Donna Brazile trying to peddle a book? I mean, because as Brianna mentioned, you know, through somebody who didn't work at CNN, she gained access to one town hall question, and she gave that, or at least attempted to, or in an email, gave it to somebody in the Clinton campaign, which is completely unethical. She lost her job. I frankly view it as a huge betrayal of everybody who worked at CNN, the fact that she did that. I don't see her attempting to give information to the Sanders campaign. It seemed like she was more than happy to cozy up to the Clinton campaign, and now she has a book to sell. She's now spinning this yarn.
You know, I feel like all this is water under the bridge. And Donna Brazile has served our party for 30 years. She's been a champion for Democrats. It was my honor and my privilege to work with her as chair of our party. I look forward to working with Donna in the future.
Do you think it was appropriate for her to do that about a town hall question?
I don't honestly know the specifics of it. It sounds like CNN looked into it and took action as they saw fit. But again, Anderson, I'm just not interested in these things in the past. This is why we've got to move beyond 2016. We have a governor's election less than a week away in Virginia. We've got critical midterm elections. And I can't say it enough. This tax plan the Republicans are proposing is okay. Outrageous. So that's the fight. That's where we need to be as Democrats.
I do also want to ask you about the dossier, obviously, because we haven't had you on the record on that. Were you aware that the Clinton campaign was at least in part funding it along with the DNC? But I'll only ask you about the Clinton campaign because the campaign chair, John Podesta, says he had no idea. I talked to Brian Fallon. He said he had no idea. I mean, it seems like nobody in the Clinton campaign has stood up and said, oh, yeah, I knew this and I was the one who helped sign off on it.
Well, look, I didn't know that we were paying the contractor that created that document. I didn't. I'll tell you, you know, what I did know, and that is that when we started to look into Donald Trump's business dealings, it was this massive tree of LLCs and shell companies. We were overwhelmed. We were out of our league on it, frankly. And so I asked our lawyer, and I gave him a budget allocation to investigate this, particularly the international aspect. My understanding is that dossier is the product of not just research that was funded by our campaign, but also by Republican donors, and that they put that all together and gave that to the press.
Right, right. Jonathan Steele was hired, I guess, after the Republican people started it, dropped out, and once you guys were paying for it. But I mean, I know the dossier was something that was compiled later. Were you or other people in the campaign, or who in the campaign was seeing the memos that Jonathan Steele was putting out? I mean, you guys are paying for opposition research. You must have been seeing the fruits of that throughout the campaign, no?
Well, we were getting briefings that were put together by the law firm with information.
Say, we've hired this guy, Jonathan Steele, and he's got sources in Russia, and this is information in drips and drabs?
What I know is that...
Christopher Steele.
Yeah, well, what I've known is what I've read in the press, that I think it was $1.2 million that was spent on this overall project, and that I think it was like $120,000, some fraction of that went to this steel company. So I don't know who else, you know, contributed to these reports.
But were you seeing...
It was packaged for us.
You must have been seeing... you're saying get briefings from the lawyer. You must have been seeing... what was it in memo form? Memos of, okay, now there's this interview and this person is saying this about the president's business dealings in Russia or this activity?
Well, when you're on a campaign, you have a strategic team and you come together and go over all this information. So our internal team was presenting information, our lawyer was presenting information, and we sort of learned things in pieces. I just can't attribute to you what piece of information, you know, came to us at what time or where it came from, frankly. You know, as campaign manager, there's a lot going on. And so I just wanted to know what was important to find out.
Okay, and just finally, is there somebody at the DNC, I mean, you were the campaign manager, is there somebody at the DNC, maybe at a slightly lower level, who knew about Christopher Steele, who didn't just know, okay, yeah, we're paying this lawyer and all of a sudden magically this information is coming back to us, who actually knew the nuts and bolts of who was gathering the information, how it was being gathered?
I don't know the answer to that. It's possible some at the DNC knew about this. We had dozens of researchers on the campaign. In fact, one of the reasons we were trying to get resources into the DNC was to make sure that they had a lot of opposition researchers working on all these Republicans. So I unfortunately don't know the answer to that.
And to those who say, you know, that this could have been some sort of collusion. If Christopher Steele is being fed disinformation from people who had connections to the Russian government, that essentially your campaign was helping pay for some of that disinformation.
Well, look, they chose what to put in that dossier. And so I can't speak to that. I'm proud that we were able to assemble some of the research that has brought this to light. Because, I mean, Anderson, you have to remember, I went on television the first day of the convention. My colleagues were on television saying something's wrong with Russia. Russia hacked the DNC. Russia, when John Podesta was hacked, Russia hacked John Podesta. And frankly, it didn't get a lot of attention. And I'm just glad that it's coming out now. I'm glad that there was research there. I can't speak to what, you know, what Fusion was doing, but I'm just glad that we're paying attention to this now. And frankly, I wish we'd paid more attention to it on the campaign.
All right, Robby Mook, appreciate your time, Robby. Thanks very much.